Hello everyone, welcome to Continental Desi Kitchen. Hope you all are doing fine. Well, in today's video we are going to see how to make restaurant style cauliflower and potato gravy, popularly known as alu gobi ki sabji, which goes very well with roti or naan. So friends, let's get started with this tasty masala alu gobi sabji recipe. For my cauliflower and potato recipe, I'll be using baby potatoes which I have washed, boiled and then peeled off the skin. Then here I have taken some cauliflower florets which I have cut into medium size, and I have half boiled them so that when you make the gravy they will not take much time to get cooked. And also I have boiled some peas along with the cauliflower. Now since everything are slightly boiled, we will first fry the cauliflower and baby potatoes golden brown. For that, heat a pan and add around 2 tablespoons of refined oil. When the oil is slightly hot, add a pinch of salt, turmeric powder and red chili powder. Now mix the spices with the oil. Now gradually add the cauliflower florets into it. And we will fry them until they are golden brown from all the sides. As you can see, the cauliflower florets are golden brown. So I will take them off and keep them aside in a plate. Similarly, I will fry the potatoes also. The bigger ones I have sliced into half and the medium ones I have kept whole. So now I will add them into the oil and fry them golden brown. The baby potatoes are also fried golden brown. So I will take them off as well. In the same karhai, add 1 more tablespoon of oil. When the oil is hot, add some cumin seeds or jeera. Let them splutter for a while. Next goes 2 bay leaves. I'll be adding now 2 medium onions which I have roughly chopped. Fry them for a while. Next goes 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, and we will fry them until the raw taste of ginger garlic goes away. Next I'll be adding tomato puree. I have used here 2 medium tomatoes. Fry until the color changes and oil separates. As you can see, the oil has separated, and now into this I'll be adding some spices like 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon jeera or cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder and 1/2 teaspoon coriander powder. Fry everything well for a while on low flame. And now I'll be adding a small bowl of beaten yogurt or dahi. This will make the gravy thick. Now give a good mix so that everything combines well. By now all the masala has been fried well. And now time to add the fried cauliflower, baby potatoes and the peas. Mix them well along with the masala. And now we will cover and cook for 2 minutes on medium flame. it's almost 2 minutes. And now I'll be adding some tomato, capsicum and onion chunks and one green chili. Mix them well. I'll be adding some water now to form a gravy-like consistency, and we'll let this simmer for 2 minutes on medium flame. So our gravy is almost done. Finally, I'll be adding 1/2 teaspoon of my homemade garam masala powder and some chopped coriander leaves. Give a final mix. That's it. My dish is now ready to be served hot. Before serving, I will give a butter tadka to my dish. For that, heat a tadka pan and add 1/2 teaspoon of refined oil and a small cube of butter. When the butter melts, I will add few ginger strands, 1/2 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder and few kasuri methi leaves. Now turn off the flame. Give this a good mix and our tadka is ready. Now pour the hot tadka over the sabji. Mix this well along with the gravy. And our cauliflower and potato gravy is ready to be served hot. And here goes our delicious masala aloo gobi ki sabji. Serve them hot with jeera rice, roti or naan. So friends, do try this tasty aloo gobi recipe. Also share your feedbacks, and if you like my today's video, then do like, share and subscribe to Continental Desi Kitchen for more yummy recipes. See you soon again in my next video. Until then, bye bye, take care and stay safe.